How's it going, everybody? So today, got an update. I don't think the telescope that I bought, and that I've been keeping a secret for like, I don't know, 6 months now, is actually gonna come in. So, yeah, I don't think the order was done correctly, and the company I bought it from just kind of blew my money, unfortunately. The telescope I bought was the Nexstar 8SE from Celestron. Yeah, and I don't think it's coming in. It's been really smoky here. I live in the northwest, and you know, we've been dealing with all the forest fires. I hope all of you guys are safe, sound. But in light of all of that, I got a new telescope today. It was off of Walmart. $200 telescope marked down to $50. Don't know what's wrong with it, but we're gonna find out and may even get some pictures tonight. It's looking kind of clear. The smoke has been clearing up, so let's get to it. Alright, so the telescope we got today is the, here, let's see here, telescope F760. That is all the information that it gives you on the box, except for some warnings about the mounting and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, let's see here. It's pretty heavy and sizable box. It's probably about a yard long by 6 to 7 inches tall. It gives you some information actually about the telescope over here. I think. Alright, so we got our lens tray. Put that there. We got some eyepieces, I guess. It just gives you what's in the box. Or boxes, rather. And this is the mount. I'm going to guess the tripod. It's three boxes. So that's the tripod mount. That's the legs. Okay. And the actual tube. Alright. Instructions. Alright. Let's see here. You guys can look at my fish back there. While we do this, alright, where do I want to start? Let's do this. Okay, let's see what kind of. Alright, looks like. What are we dealing with? It's aluminum. That's nice. Obviously, goes like that. Where did I put it? Let me reach behind you guys. There we go. Box knife. If you're under 18, under 16, I guess. Use adult supervision for using scissors, knives, whatever. Let's see. Yep. Tripod leg number one. Two and number three. Okay, so first off, don't like that the tightening screws. The legs aren't automatically attached. It's kind of a in my book. I don't really like that. Alright, let's see what's in this one, the one with all the pieces on it. Okay. A little finder scope. Made out of plastic. The tray mount, I'm guessing. Yes, tray mount. This is one of the directional up and down type deal. This is the 3x Barlow. Your lenses. Your nuts and bolts. Cleaning cloth. And 15x erecting eyepiece. Don't quite know. And your, I wouldn't quite say 90 degree eyepiece attachment. Alright, let's see about
this.
Alright, again, tray's plastic. This trip. Okay, let's take a look at the actual scope. Alright. I hope they... Yes, alright. Model 760 telescope. Focal length is 700 millimeters. Diameter is, I'm guessing that's what it is. It says diam, D-I-A-M, is 60 millimeters. Yeah, okay. And this is a refractor. Just in case anybody was wanting to know, I'm just kind of peeking through it. Alright, what do we do first? I guess we set up the tripod first. This may be a little sketchy. You see what I mean? I don't like that. So, why don't we get those nuts in there first? So the only thing in this that is actually metal is the the only thing that's metal is the leg mount and the actual scope itself, which I guess is okay. I mean, it was $50, so, you know, it's definitely okay. Alright. Gonna speed through this part just because it's the same thing 3x. Alright, so we got all the nuts in, or the bolts rather. Okay. I guess there's not a specific way that these go. Again, probably just fast forward through this. Okay, so they have it. There's a nut, washer, and a bolt washer, and it looks like a butterfly nut goes through here. mix these two. Uh-oh. Is it just that, or... There we go. Okay. And then that goes here, and tighten it up. Alright, I'll see you guys once I have the mount all done. Alright, so I've got that all together. It's kind of funky, but it'll work. Alright, now I guess it's probably this guy next. That will go in here, obviously. So again, gotta use both hands for this, and I'll see you guys here in a sec. Alright, so that was pretty simple. All you gotta do is pretty much just what you do up here. Just thread the bolt through and put the nut on. It is a locking nut, so it's pretty simple. Alright, let's get this on. Alright, it comes with its own... Look, let me see if I can... There we go. Comes with its own nut. Oh, let's get these legs. Alrighty, there we have it. Now, should probably mount the scope next, so that probably will go this way. I'll be using these bigger nuts. Oops, sorry about that. Alright, getting the actual scope mounted with these right here. Alright, still moves. Moves very well, in fact. Yeah, it seems that there is no... Okay, there is locking in the scope in place, okay. Oh, I gotta put that down. Okay. Whoa. Don't do that. That's very bad. Ouch. Okay, there we have it. Now it seems the... I don't like where they have this, but we'll use it there anyway. Whoops. Don't lose your nuts, people. Do be careful with them. Alright. That just goes there. Yeah, don't lose the nuts like I just did. It's okay. Assuming it goes just like that. I'm going to face this down. It's taking this up so it won't move like that. Alright, I'm going to leave that just free swinging. This, I mean, it seems to be kind of a counterweight type deal. But I guess not. Okay. Alright, and then you have the option of the vertical eyepiece, which I guess you just take this cap out, put this in, and screw it in like any other eyepiece. And Barlow lens, all that kind of stuff, and I will see you guys back later.